Hari Om. We shall chant the Shanti Mantra. Om Vang Me Manasi Pratishthita. Mano Me Vache Pratishthitam. Aviravirma Edhi. Vedasya Maani Isthaha. Shrutam Me Ma Prahasi. Anena dhite na horatran sandadhami. Ritam vadishyami. Satyam vadishyami. Tanmam avatu. Tad vaktaram avatu. Avatu mam, avatu vaktaram, avatu vaktaram. Om shanti shanti shanti.
Om shanti shanti.
We shall chant all the mantras. Om Atma va idam eka eva agra asit. Om Atma va idam eka eva agra asit. Nanyat kinchana mishata. Saikshata. Lokanushruja iti Saiman Lokan Ashrujata Ambho Marichi Maramapo Ado Ambha Parena Divam Dyav Pratishtha Antariksham Marichayah Prithivi Maro Ya Adastata Apaha Sa Ikshate Me Nulokah Lokapalanushruja Iti Sodhyaya eva purusham samudhrutya murchayata tamabhyatapata tasya vitaptasya mukham nirabhityata yathandam mukhad vagvachognihi Nasike nirabhidyetam Nasikabhyam prana pranadvayuhu Akshini nirabhidyetam Akshibhyam chakshush chakshusha adityah Karno nirabhidyetam Karnabhyam shrotram shrotradishah Tvang nirabhidyata Tvacho lomani lomabhya aushadhi vanaspatayo Hridayam nirabhidyata Hridayan mano Manasaschandramaha Nabhi nirabhidyata Nabhyam apano. Apanan mrityuhu. Shishnam niravidyata. Shishnad retaha. Retasa apaha. So, Om Atma va idam eka eva agra asit. Aham eva asam, asam eva agre. In Srimad Bhagavat also, there is this Chatushloki Bhagavat, the very essence of Bhagavat in four verses. Though there are some 24,000 verses, I think. But in four verses, the essence of Bhagavat was given. And the first verse in that is Aham eva asam, asam eva agre. That I alone was there, and I alone was there. Nobody else was there. Then everything happened. So Atma or Brahma alone was there before all these names and forms, before this Jagat came into being, only that Self alone was there. See, in that Brahma, potentially, the world, Ishvara, Maya, Jagat, Jiva, all of them were there. Just as in a piece of stone, all the murtis are there. Or in gold, all the ornaments are there, potentially. If you try to look for those ornaments, they are not there. Only gold is there. Or in a pen, potentially all the great poems and all the great art, literature is there. But if you look into it, you will not find anything. So in that Brahma, potentially, the Jagat, Jiva, Ishvara, Maya, and the Vedas, all of them are there. Therefore, it is said the Vedas are Nitya, Ishvara is also Nitya. Ishvara Shakti is also Nitya, Jagat is also Nitya, Jivas are also Nitya. Jiva, when comes to recognize his own self as Brahma, identifies with that Brahma, becomes one with that Brahma. Brahma with Brahma eva bhavati. So from that Atma or Brahma, everything came into being. So that Atma as Ishvara, he thought, kisa ikshata, let me lokanu shrujayati, that let me create this world. And that thought also came because of all the jivas and their vasanas and their desires are there. They should have some field wherein they can express or experience the result of their desire. So Ishvara, from Ishvara came Hiranyagarbha or Brahmaji, who was given the Vedas and also the power to create. Then the Virat Purush also came into being. And a description of that Virat, yesterday we saw that how from that water itself, water of creation, as though Bhagwan created that Virat Purush. And in that Virat, the mouth, the eyes, the ear, the nose, and the respective sense organs were created, and the respective devatas, who are the protectors of those organs as well as their own field, they are the protectors. So Vayu Devata, Agni Devata, Yama, and Varuna, and Dig Devata, Aditya, Chandrama, all of them were created they came into being, they came into manifestation. They are potentially there, but they came into manifestation. And then through each of the sense organ, they came into, these devatas also respectively came into manifestation. So the Virat Purush is being described here, and the Lokapalas are born. Then what happened? That we will see now. Second section, Dvitiya Khanda. Ta eta devataha shrishtaha asmin mahati arnave prapatan tam ashanaya pipasabhyam anvavarjata ta enam abruvan ayatanam na prajanihi yasmin pratishthita annam adameti. Let us, you repeat. Ta eta devata shrishtaha asmin mahartyarnave prapatan tam ashanaya pipasabhyam anvavarjata ta enam abruvan ayatanam na prajanihi yasmin pratishthita annam adameti. It's very good to chant his Vedic mantras. So ta eta devataha shrishtaha. So all these devatas who were created, Agni, Varuna, Vayu, Aditya, Chandrama, etc. When they were born, shrishtaha asmin mahati arnave prapatan, they all fell down as though in this great ocean of samsara. All these devatas, lokpalas, they fell down in this great ocean of samsara. See, if you go to the karmakanda portion of Vedas, they mention various different types of rituals to propitiate these devatas. So Agni is propitiated, Indra, Varuna, and all those devatas. But here it is said these devatas themselves have fallen into this samsara. So the devatas are also jivas only, of a higher category. So this infinite variety of jivas are there. So this higher than human being, there are those higher devatas in which even the Gandharvas and Yaksha, Kinnara, and these devatas are there. And the king of all the devata is Indra. But they too have the same raga, dvesha, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, etc. They have their own problems. We think we have problems, devatas also have their problems. Now and then the asuras keep on torturing them. They have a fight, they have so much of happening. So if somebody does yajna, yaga and collects lot of punya, he becomes devata. And there again, same problem. So one way the scripture is also saying that the result which one obtains through the karma, karma kanda, etc., they have their own limitation. Though when we perform this yajna, the respective devatas give the result. In Bhagavad Gita also Bhagavan says that you propitiate these devatas, and they will propitiate you. So helping each other, both of you will attain Shreya. Shreyo nu apnuyan. Both of you, parasparam bhavayan, helping each other, you attain the Shreya. So the appropriate mantras when we chant to propitiate these devatas, they also help us by their own power, because they are controlling our senses, our mind, our intellect. All that we experience in this world ultimately depends on our mind, intellect and senses. The one who controls them is the boss. Just like our mobile or our other equipments are there, the internal things control that equipment. If it is of a low quality, or if there are some viruses or some defect in them, the whole instrument will function in a bad way. Therefore, every now and then they come up with a new model, just for fun actually. They themselves keep some defect, I think, and next time they remove it and they say new model has come. Immediately we rush to buy that. Then again they will say improved version, better pixels and better thing and all. Then again we run. So they are controlling the internal, those all these devatas of that mobile. Similarly, all the senses, our mind, our intellect are not only, they are used by us, but they are in a cosmic level, they are controlled by these devatas. We use our eyes, but how effective our eyes will be depends on the Aditya Devata. We use our mind, but how effective our mind will depend on Chandrama. Sometimes the other devatas also can influence our mind. The story in Ramayana, when they were doing, Rakshasas were doing tapas, Ravan and Kumbhakarna and Vibhishan, and the devatas were frightened that this Kumbhakarna, if he starts eating, all our food will be eaten by him only. So they requested, when he was about to ask for the boon, they requested Saraswati Mata, that please, she is the Vani, Devata of the Vani. So you please do something by which he will be able to say something else. So he wanted Indrapad. Something happened and he said Nidrapad. Nidrapad mere ko de do. Acha, le lo. Just like Narad ji, he had asked that give me the rupa of Hari. But Hari also means Bandar. So Bhagavan gave him Bandar ka rup. Therefore you should learn Sanskrit properly. Otherwise it will be terrible. One person had some very horrible looks. So he was asked that what happened. He said that I prayed to God and he came and he asked me that do you want brain? And I heard train. I said no. Then he asked me, do you want books? He said no. Then he asked me, do you want a rose? And I heard nose. He said, give me a big red one. So he had no brains, no, I think looks, Bhagavan has, and he heard books. And no looks, and a big red nose. So one should be very careful when dealing with God. So, when all these our devatas, They control our senses, our mind, our intellect, but they are also higher jiva with higher authority. They have their post, like Yamraj, as I said yesterday, is a post. Similarly, all these devatas, they have their own post. But there is hierarchy. Above them is also someone. Above them is someone. And above everyone is Ishvara, the Supreme Lord. So these devatas, when they were created, they also fell into this ocean of samsara. Mahati arnave prapatan. They fell down. Then Bhagwan also subjected to them, subjected them to hunger and thirst. Tam ashanaya pipasabhyam anvavarjata. He also subjected all these devatas with hunger and thirst. Ashanaya pipasa. Therefore, all our senses and the mind and intellect, they are always hungry and thirsty, always have desire in them, always want to experience more and more and more, always thirsty. So the eyes are not satisfied, it wants to see more and more. Ears want to hear, tongue wants to taste different food. So the hunger and thirst is also there in each of these devatas. Therefore they are there, hunger and thirst are there in each of our sense organs, also in the mind and intellect. So tam ashanaya pipasabhyam anvavarjata. Now this was created, then these devatas approached Ishvara and they requested, ki ta enam abruvan ayatanam na prajanihi. That, oh Lord, please give us ayatanam, give us some place where we can stay and experience all this and indulge in fulfilling our hunger and thirst. Satiating our hunger, quenching our thirst, give us some ayatanam, a place, a body, by which we can experience all this. Yasmin pratishthita annam adam eti, so that we can stay in this ayatanam, in this place, get well established there, and eat the various annam. Annam means food. Food doesn't mean just the cooked food, but food, whatever we experience through our senses. So what the eyes see is the food for the eye. What the ears hear is food for the ears. So may we get a good ayatanam by which we can reside there and experience these joys and sorrows of this world. The whole thing is given, expressed in a very, very dramatic and very poetic way, but one has to contemplate and understand. From this we will be able to understand our own personality. We will be able to understand how the senses function and what are the various devatas of the senses, etc. So when the devatas were endowed with this hunger and thirst, and when they requested for this ayatanam, then what happened further? Tabhyo gaman ayata. Tabhyo gaman ayata. Tabhyo gama anayata. Ta abruvan navai no ayam alamiti. Tabhyo ashvam anayata. Ta abruvan Navaino ayamalamiti. Tabyogama anayata. Ta abruvan. Navaino yamalamiti. Tabyo ashwamanayata. Ta abruvan. Navaino yamalamiti. Tabhyo gam anayata. To them, Bhagwan first created a cow. Cow, you know. So created a cow and brought it in front of all these devatas. You want a place to stay? You stay in this cow. So they looked at this cow. They checked it out, all the devatas. And then they said, Ta abruvan, they told Bhagwan, ki navai naha ayam alamiti, for us, this cow is not enough. For us, this cow, this particular equipment, is not enough. See, the devatas, all the senses, the mind, the intellect, our ahankar, chitta, all the equipments which are there within, they cannot be expressed fully in all the bodies. There are various different here, just as a sample, the cow and the ashva is mentioned. But all the variety of beings who are there, the animal, birds, plant, all of them, they are good, but they have their own limitation. When these devatas want to express through those bodies, they cannot express fully. In fact, all the devatas also cannot get accommodation in that one body. There are some beings who have only one sense organ. There are some which has got two sense organs. Some have three, some have four. Like the prithvi is also considered a living organism with only one sense organ, that is touch. I think in some language it is also called Gaya. Gaya means not our Gaya, but G-A-I-A. The whole world is one living organism. So like that, various beings are there. But in all of them, all the devatas cannot express themselves fully. Apart from sense organ, then the mind is there. For the mind also, proper equipment is required. Heart is required. For the ahankar also, for buddhi also, proper equipment is required. For the chitta to express, proper equipment is required. So when Bhagwan presented the cow, they must have used it, just like when you are presented a mobile, you use it, but then you say, oh, na ayam alamiti. This is not enough for me. Nahin ho jayega. The old, suppose somebody gives you phone without any facilities for taking photograph or sending your mails or this, that and all, you will say, na ayam alamiti. This is not enough for me. I will give this to grandma and take another one. Because for some people and all, they too many of these facilities, they get scared. They said, nahin, 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 ye nahin chahiye mujhe baba. Just give me a phone where I can make call and receive call, bas. I don't want anything else. Similarly, there are some equipments, creatures, where only few things function. Means all the devatas cannot function fully. So the cow was brought and the devatas said that, na ayam alam. Alam means enough. This is not enough for us. Then Bhagwan created a ashva. Ashva means a horse, a powerful horse. Ashvam. Anayat. Again they checked the ashva And they said, Kita abruvan na vai no ayam alamiti, that this ashva is also not enough for us. We can't express ourselves fully in this ashva. Some devatas get left out. So we can't. It's like suppose you go to a, you get transferred to from a city to a some village where the electricity is not functioning properly, where other facilities are not there, where only one tower is there, mobile, far away, where you have to climb a tree to really catch the signal. And only in a particular posture you can catch it. Then you will say, na ayam alamiti. Ye mere ko theek nahi hai, baba. Like that, all the devatas, they could not, they were not satisfied with the horse also. Then, what did Bhagavan do? Very interesting. Tabhya purusham anayata. Ta abruvan sukrutam bateti purusho vava sukrutam ta abravit yathayatanam pravishateti tabhya purusham anayat ta abruvan sukrutam bateti purusho vava sukrutam ta abravit yathayatanam pravishat iti tabhya purusham anayat. Then Bhagavan brought in front of them, all these devatas, a purusha. Purusha means a human being. A human being. This human being was created in the same image of that Virat Purush. So, human being was brought in front of these devatas. Then those devatas saw this human being and entered that, checked that human being, and they were very happy. Abruvan sukrutam bateti, this is the perfect. Sukrutam, very good. All of them said that this is well made, very good, perfect. It's very important and interesting that we take our own life and our own this what you call body and all for granted, but it is the most perfect and most amazing equipment. If you compare with other beings also, a human being has transcended all other beings far, far and far, far away. As far as the equipment is concerned, how we use it is a different matter. But the equipment, for example, the mind, the intellect, the chitta, these are finer equipments. Other senses and all are there, they are also important. But our mind, our intellect, mana, buddhi, chitta, ahankar, they are also there. They are also equipments, instruments which we are using. But they can be used to the best in a human body only. We have the capacity to see, hear, taste, touch. Humans are the only creature who can live in all conditions. Human beings have been living under the sea also, they go. Even sometimes the fish and all are surprised to see, what is this fellow doing here? Deep below we go, we can live there. We live not only on the temperate climate like our India and all, we have gone up north. People are staying now in Arctic region, Antarctic region. Cold, snow everywhere. But waha they stay. They have the capacity to live there also. not that their body is very strong, but their mind is, intellect is very strong. If we don't have proper condition, we create proper condition and stay there. Now they are planning to stay on Mars also. First they will send all the equipment there, prepare the place, they will tent and all. Prepare the place for people to go and stay there permanently. You can give your name also, it came in the newspaper, those who want to go. But one way ticket, because to again to take off from Mars and come back here, it requires more, it is not possible at this stage. Because again to land there, from here they will have to carry the fuel for return journey and all those things. It's very complicated and very costly. So they are planning. Anyway, so one day they will settle on Mars also. They will settle on, now we have this, what we call that space station. People are staying there, in between space. Not on Moon, not on Earth, but in between, for months together. Even our Indian, that lady is staying there. She came back. So, human equipment is one of the most amazing equipment that even the devtas, they also feel jealous. They also want to become human being. It's most amazing. Human being, both man and woman, both are, huh? Human being means, here when it is said Purusha, Purusha is not only man, but woman also. So we have the most perfect equipment. It is said that even the capacity of our brain is so much that only 3 or 4% of its capacity is being used. Even the capacity of our senses is so much powerful. As we evolve, as we become better and better, maybe in future, all these capacities will get heightened also. Now we are using only a very less percentage of our capacity, of the senses, of the mind, of the intellect. In the mind, we have the capacity to by heart all the knowledge available in the world, all the libraries. That much storage capacity is there. It's very amazing. It's quite amazing. And the way it is stored is also a great mystery. It is stored in what they call a holographic way. Means even in one portion of the brain, all the message of other portion also are there, hidden. In a very strange way, the storage is being done in our brain. Now they are understanding the brain and using similar technology for our mobile and all, like we have those clouds and all. So this is a very interesting equipment which we have, where all the devatas, which are mentioned here, all the devatas, they occupy this body and they have full scope for expressing in their full measure. Therefore, it is considered the best. See, other creatures on earth, they don't even stand close to us in terms of our progress as far as our intellect, our mind and all is concerned. All the creatures, still they are living in a very bad condition. They have not evolved to create equipments or to deal with the nature and all. But human beings have. It's a big jump. It's the most amazing thing. So, abruvan sukrutam bateti. So they, all of them, were very pleased and very happy. And they said that this is the most wonderfully done. Because it is done in the, as in Bible also it is said, that it is done in the image of God. We are created in the image of God. So we are created in the image of that Virat Purush. Therefore the Virat Purush is also described as having eyes, ears, nose. Bahura janyakritaha uru tadasya yadvaishyaha. padbhyagam shudro ajayata chandrama manaso jatah chakshush what do you call mukhadindra chagnischa pranad vayura jayata. So all these limbs are there in this. So the entire cosmos is like a person only, our replica. Therefore it is said yatha pinde tatha brahmande. And this description is there in the scriptures. So yatha pinde tatha brahmande. Just like our little cell also, if you see, it's quite amazing. Even our solar system, if you see, the sun and all the planets rotating, revolving around it. If you see a tiny little atom, also you will find a similar structure, like the nucleus is there and the electrons are revolving around it. So whatever is there in one unit, we find same in that totality also. But this is very much true as far as human being is concerned. So human equipment is considered to be the best, the top, crown of creation. All the devatas were very happy. Abruvan sukrutam bateti, purusho vava sukrutam. They said that this purusha, human being, is sukrutam. Bhagavan says, don't keep on praising, now do one thing. He said, what? Kita abravit, Ishvara told them, ki yatha ayatanam pravishat iti, that according to your own place, ayatam, you enter this body. For the eye, the devata of the eye is Aditya. So Aditya should enter the eye. For the tongue, what you call, yeah, the devata is Agni. So fire should enter the mouth. Like that, he told all the devatas that you enter this body in your respective places. Don't fight. Don't enter the wrong place and then... Ne? Sometimes you go to camp and all, and this big hangama is there. कि मेरे को ये कमरा क्यों दिया बाथरूम के सामने और उनको पूरा एकदम हिमालय का दर्शन होता है और मेरे को यहाँ पर यह सो बिग हंगामा कम्स सो यर देयरफॉर भगवान सेड आई हैव ऑलरेडी अलॉटेड यू द प्लेसेस सो यू प्लीज गो एंड सेटल इन दोज प्लेसेस सो ता अब ब्रवीत यथा आयतनम प्रविशत इति. Then all these devatas, they entered these places in our body. So how they entered? Next mantra. Agnirvag bhutva mukham pravishata vayu prano bhutva नासिके प्राविशत आदित्यश्चक्षुर्भूत्वा अक्षिणी प्राविशत दिशश्रोत्रं भूत्वा कर्णौ प्राविशन् ओषधीवनस्पतयो लोमानि भूत्वा त्वचं प्राविशन् चंद्रमा मनो भूत्वा हृदयं प्राविशन् मृत्युपानो भूत्वा नाभिं प्राविशत् आपोरेतो भूत्वा शिष्णं प्राविशन् अग्निः वाग् भूत्वा सो अग्नि देवता बिकेम द वाग् वाग् मीन्स द ऑर्गन ऑफ स्पीच इज सटल बट इट रिसाइड्स इन अवर माउथ इन अवर टंग द प्लेस ऑफ रेसिडेंस for this organ of speech is the mouth, but it is the mouth itself is not the organ of speech. It is subtler. Therefore, it is part of the sukshma sharira. So the capacity to speak is there within each one of us. Even when a person is some problem with the tongue or with his whatever the organ, physical, may not be able to speak, but the speech is there. And very interesting, this language also is quite amazing. Language also has got its origin from the beginningless time. They did one, not an experiment, but it happened by chance. I think it was in Hawaii Island. They wanted to have these crops of sugarcane. And they got workers to work there from all over the world, different husband and wife. From all parts of the world they came. And it so happened that all of them were speaking different language. So whatever they have to speak, only the wife could understand or husband could understand. Nobody could understand. So it was very difficult for them to interact with. So somehow they, with sign language and all, they interacted. Then the children were born. And a very amazing thing started happening. The children started interacting with other children. And just everyone's language was different. But just by interacting with them, slowly they developed a language with all the grammar and all the rules, with all so many words, they developed that language. I think it is called Croatian or something. They developed this language and they started speaking. Little children, how could they do it? That samskar of that language is also part of our samskar. Not exactly Hindi, Marathi or Sanskrit or something, but that language, universal, there is some language with universal grammar which is there in all beings. Even in animals it is there. Therefore, animals also convey. The first, the meaning comes in their head and they convey it. How they convey, human beings convey through words. But these animals, they can convey through other means. For example, if you see the world of bees, honeybees, they have amazing way of conveying. So there are bees who goes in search of the flowers. And they will find out some place where there are flowers. Then they will come back. And the other bees are there. And they will dance in front of those bees. I don't know their dance. But they dance. And from their dance, the other bees come to know exactly where the flower is, where they have to go. Without that bee coming and accompanying, either jao left mid turn karo. Without that bee accompanying them, these other bees exactly reach that spot. From their dance, they tell not only the plane in which it is there, the angle, this, that and all, I don't know how, but exactly the other bees, they reach that place. They convey. The meaning is there in their head. They convey it through their dancing language. Similarly, there are other creatures, like even ant, they can also convey. Ki wahan par left side mein laddu rakha hua hai. Vaishna Devi ka prasad hai. Kha lo jaake. So, they can also convey. So, very amazing things are there. So we are born with a natural that language in us. We give words, we give some other names to it and we speak, but that language is there. And that natural language and the natural grammar which is there in every being was discovered by our great Rishi Munis. It is there in the Vedas, but the great Rishi Munis gave it words like the Panini grammar is the natural grammar of human being or all creatures. Then whether we outwardly speak English, Hindi, Marathi, it has essentially that grammar is there. In the perfect sense, it is there in Sanskrit, but other languages also have it. So Agni Devata became what? Vak, speech, and entered the mouth. Therefore, sometimes we use the term, he gave a fiery speech. And they spoke and created more fire than light. They had a heated discussion. So, speech. And it is also said that if we drink nice ghee and all, it is good for our speech. In the olden time, they used to drink ghee. Anyway, I won't go in detail about ghee. But Agnir Vak Bhutva Mukham Pravishata. So Agni Devata became Vak, Vani, and entered the mouth. Then Vayuhu Prano Bhutva Nasike Pravishata. So Vayu Devata became Prana. Mainly here the breathing. And this organ of smell. So it entered the nostril, becoming the organ of smell. There are some people who have great sense of smell. Some animals, they have terrific sense of smell. Dogs and all. They can smell drugs, they can smell other things. Even they are training those honeybees to locate those drugs and all. How they train, I don't know, but they have this. Unko train karte hai. So they catch. So Vayuhu Pranaha Bhutva Nasike Pravishata. So Vayu Devata has entered our nostril to become the prana. Means that Vayu. We breathe in and out. What do we breathe in and out? Vayu only. All of us sitting here, we are breathing in and out that oxygen. But that oxygen, how it enters inside and comes out, it's because of that Vayu Devata. If that Devata is not happy, Vayu can go out and may not return also. Therefore, there is a saying in Sanskrit that we don't know when this Vayu will become Ruddha, will become what you call angry with us, that he will go and will not come back. So Vayu Prano Bhutva Nasike Pravishata. Then Adishcha Chakshuhu Bhutva Akshini Pravishata. Then Aditya Devata, the Devata of light. Even the sun is Aditya Devata, Devata of light. And without this light, our eyes cannot see. So outside, if you want to see, we require the physical light. But with our eyes closed also we can see. The seeing of that eyes are always there. Even a blind person, as I said, can see nothing. We close our eyes, we say, I am seeing nothing. But I am seeing that darkness. That ability to see is quite amazing. And that is because of this Aditya Devata. So Aditya Chakshuhu Bhutva Akshini Pravishata has entered the eyes. Then Dishaha, Disha Devata, Devata of directions, Dig Devata or space. We have these various directions, east, west, north, south, and in between direction, then up and down. Dasho Disha, 10 directions normally they say. So up, down and this 8. Sometimes we get lost. So Dig Brahma it is called, lost. Ki yahan jana hai ki vahan jana hai. That called Dig Brahma. So this Dig Devata is entered our ears. So space. Therefore, in between our ears, there is space. Lot of space is there. So dig devata shrotram bhutva karna pravishat. So the karna, which we can see the ears, physical ears, are just a place. It's called a golaka, a place. But in that place stays the organ of hearing. And with the devata, dig devata. So dishat shrotram bhutva karna. Therefore, the scriptures also say that you have to offer this good food to those devatas. They are sitting in all the organs, so offer them. So one should eat, see, taste, touch, those things which can be offered to those devatas. Should not give them just like that. Should give them good food to those devatas. So dishah shrotram bhutva karna pravishat pravishan. Then oshadhi vanaspatayo lomani bhutva twacham pravishat pravishan. Oshadhi, all the herbs, all the medicinal plants and herbs and various types of other vanaspatis, they all became the loma, our hairs on our body, and they entered the twacha, the skin. So oshadi vanaspatayo lomani bhutva twacham pravishan, they entered the skin. The skin, the sense of touch, is the broadest our organ all over the body, ability to touch and understand. So even with my eyes closed, I touch, I know, I can feel, I can experience that touch. So for that also that light is required. Light doesn't mean that physical light only. Light is that which reveals. Therefore these devatas are also, the meaning of those devatas also is that which illumines. The one who illumines. Dyotanat devaha. They illumine. So the skin illumine touch. The ears illumine sound. The eyes illumine form and color. So oshadhi vanaspatayo lomani bhutva twacham pravishan. So all the great vanaspatis and oshadhis and all are there on our skin only. I don't know, as we understand the secret, we will be able to understand it. All the medicines are there on our skin. How and all, I don't know. And in our, this loma. So, oshadhi vanaspatayo lomani bhutva twacham pravishan. Then chandrama, the devata, chandrama devata. Not the physical moon, but the chandrama devata, who is the devata of our mind. He became the mind and entered our heart. Chandrama mano bhutva hridayam pravishan. So the mind functions from our heart. The emotions functions from our heart. Not the physical heart, but somewhere near that heart. When a person is sad, mad, red, he feels that in his heart. When you get hurt, you don't feel it in your head. I am very hurt. I am very hurt. Love, kindness, anger, jealousy is felt in the heart. Somewhere to the right hand side of the physical heart. That is the heart where the mind functions. This brain actually, it has got its own, I don't know what function, but mind functions from that heart. So hridayam, chandrama mano bhutva hridayam pravishan. Then mrityuhu, mrityu devata, yamraji. Yamraji is not far away, he is there also in our body. Yamraji doesn't stay up in heaven somewhere. So mrityu also, apano bhutva, he becoming apanavayu. Nabhim pravishat, he entered our nabhi, navel. So in the navel, Mrityu Devata is seated there. Now and then you can touch and check it out. Mrityu Devata has entered our body, becoming apana and residing in the nabhi. So mrityu apano bhutva nabhim pravishat. Then apo reto bhutva shishnam pravishan. Apaha, water. Water devata. Varuna devata. Devata of water. Water is also another very amazing creation of Bhagwan. Though if physically, chemically, if we see, we say that it is made up of oxygen and hydrogen. Both oxygen and hydrogen are gas. Both of them are quite, they catch fire. Hydrogen, very dangerous. Hydrogen gas and all suddenly catches fire. So this oxygen, hydrogen, when they come together, a very strange, another element is born, liquid, water. It quenches our thirst. It cools down the fire also. Without water, we can't survive. Water is the most beautiful. All of them are beautiful, but water is very beautiful. And the most amazing thing is that it has got, this water has got so many properties which we are not even aware of. Like, if suppose somebody says this water can, whatever you do, it will, the color will remain transparent only. But no, it can become white. The water can become white like rui, as snow. It can turn into gas. It can become solid. So it's the most amazing. So this Varuna Devata has become Retaha, the semen, the seed, and Shishnam Pravishan, and entered the generative organ. So Devata has entered the generative organ and reside there. So all these Devatas, when they saw the human body, they were very pleased and they entered this body. Therefore, even now, that was first time, so even now, all the Devatas are there in all our bodies. Then further, tam ashanaya pipase abhrutam avabhyam abhipraja nihitim te abravid etasveva vam devata svabhajami etasu bhaginyam karomite tasmat yasya kasya cha devatayai havir grihyate bhaginya vevasyam ashanaya pipase bhavatah. Then this ashana pipasa, they were also created. They approached Bhagwan Ishvara and they said that please give us also some place to stay. Tam ashanaya pipase abhrutam ki avabhyam abhiprajanihi. Please bring some abode for us also to reside. Where will we reside in this body? All the places, important places are taken by all these devatas. Vahan jaake baith gaye sab log. Hum kahan baithenge? Where will we sit? See, in the Somewhere there is a mantra also. These devatas, all of them are sitting in our senses. And when we sit for meditation and all, they don't like it. Devatas don't like meditation. So balat, they will open the senses and allow the objects to enter. Dhyan karne baith gaye to kitchen se achhi sugandh aa jati hai. The devata will open the nostril wider. So that you go and satisfy them. So tam ashanaya pipase abhrutam ki avabhyam abhiprajani hiti. Please bring us also some abode where we can reside. Then Bhagavan told ki aap logo ko separate abode I will not make. That separate horn then where ashana pipasa can reside. No, he said, ab te abravid etasu eva vam devatasu abhajami. That in this, along with this devata only, I will make you your abode, you can reside with them. With each and every devata, you reside, ashana pipasa. Therefore, with each and every sense organ, with each and every our other organ, mind, intellect and all, this ashana pipasa are also there. Hunger and thirst, desire, the senses, the mind are always thirsty. You can never satisfy them. Because that is the very nature of ashana and pipasa. Ashana means hunger. Always hungry. Only for a short time we say, bas ho gaya. As soon as that is digested again, we want. Oh, gulab jamun bhi maine rakha hai, abhi kha leta hun. And after overeating, we go to the doctor. The doctor says, ye goli kha lo. He said, itni jagah hoti to wo rasgulla kha nahi leta main. So, ashana pipasa is always there. In all the sense organs, they are waiting. So the whole personality, if we appreciate and understand, it is very good. So te abravet etaso evavam devataso abhajami etaso bhaginyau karomi te. You will be bhagini, you will partner, you will cooperate, you will be along with this devata. You will share that abode with the devata. And whatever, tasmad yasya kasya cha devata ye havir grahyate, whatever havi, whatever food, whatever is offered to this devata, you can also then participate in that. You will also get it. When the devata eats, that eating will go to that hunger and thirst. So you will also get your share. Whatever is given to the devata will go to you. But this, as I said, this hunger and thirst are always there. Therefore it is said in the scripture that the more you feed them, the more it hungry one becomes. It is like fire. The more fuel you put, the more it starts burning. Our senses can never be satisfied with the pleasures of the sense objects. Never. Because the hunger and thirst is there with them. It is not possible. This was understood by Nachiketa. Nachiketa told Yamraja ki, I don't want all these pleasures of the heavens and all. Tava eva vahas tava nritya gite jarayanti tejaha. That all these pleasures will make my tej of the senses also will go away. So please give me the knowledge of that self, by which I will become free of all this hunger and thirst forever. So etasu bhaginyam karomiti tasmat yasya kasya cha devata ye havir grihyate bhaginyaveva asyam ashanaya pipase bhavatah. So whenever something is offered to this devata, this ashana pipasa, hunger and thirst also become they get their share. They partake of that. So in this way, Bhagavan made the, first he created the world, the four, then he brought out that Virat Purush, then he made all these devatas, the lokpalas, and then he brought this ayatanam for them, the beautiful human body. Other bodies are also there, but there the devatas are not fully satisfied. So finally they became satisfied in a human body, and they have their respective abode and all. So this much creation we have seen now, but it is not in complete. Still lot is there. So we will continue tomorrow. Now we have 5 minutes, to be precise 7 minutes. So till 8 o'clock it is my time, I can do whatever. So 7 minutes I have. Once the 7 minutes is over, you are free to get up and go. But before that I will conclude. So close your eyes and bring your attention to the present moment. Become aware of your body. Become aware of this beautiful equipment which Ishvara has made with his own hands, the beautiful human body. It's a masterpiece. Then the 5 organs of action, the 5 organs of perception, each one of them again the masterpiece, the very height of perfection. The pancha pranas move in our body, keep it working. Subtler than these pranas, subtler than the senses, is our mind. Our ahankar, buddhi, chitta, all this mana, buddhi, chitta, ahankar, they have their own devatas. They are also residing within. Mana, buddhi, chitta, ahankar, always hungry and thirsty for new, for more experiences. And unless they are satisfied, we feel restless, uncomfortable. So this goes on and on. This is the samsara, running after various experiences non-stop from one lifetime to another lifetime. Be grateful that you have got this human body through which we can also realize God. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.